will bear much fruit.
Connected to God, grafted onto that vine, the strength of that connection can change depending upon the decisions we make. And when that connection is strong, when that branch has a lot of surface area with the vine, when that hardware is in place to hold us fast onto the one who is life, good things happen. And when that occurs, God's life and goodness is able to flow freely into us, inspiring us, comforting us, and strengthening us for a life of faith. However, just because we have a part to play in strengthening our connection with our God, it doesn't mean that we do so by ourselves, isolated or alone. But let me be clear. I'm not saying that it's not important to work on this bond privately, in the quiet of our rooms, and in the silence of our hearts. No, it is important to have those kinds of one-on-one experiences with God, wrestling with the big questions about life and faith through quiet time and contemplation, poring over sacred scripture, bringing our individual needs to our God in prayer. All that is good. But we also have something else, another precious gift from our God to help us on this journey, to help us keep a strong connection between Him and us, the church. The role of the church in our lives, in the Catholic faithful, is something that many non-Catholics can have a problem with. Many see the church as simply a bunch of extra stuff that is completely unnecessary in their mind. Can't I pray to God in my home? Can't God speak to me while I'm reading and praying scripture? Can't God help me in my conscience and help me make good decisions? Can't I live a decent, faithful life on my own? Why do I need this thing called church? It's interesting to note that these feelings are not exclusively found in the hearts and minds of some non-Catholic people. They are often expressed by some of the church as well, as by many who have maybe recently left the church. And the reasons are many. But part of it stems simply from the way we view the church. Maybe it's because of the way it was presented to us as young people, or maybe because we perceive it to be filled with so many rules, or maybe because of recent scandals that have been more than a little disheartening. Whatever the reasons, many of the faithful participate in church somewhat reluctantly or begrudgingly, as something that we may have to do, or something bad might happen. And that can lead us to start thinking of the institutional church as kind of an obstacle to faith. And that's a shame. But when we start to harbor those feelings, we may start failing to notice all the blessings that continually come to us through the church, the graces that flow through into our hearts and minds and souls of the faithful. Our church is not meant to be a burden. It's meant to be a gift, a treasure of opportunities and possibilities for us to remain securely attached to that vine. Our Lord Jesus wants us to stay securely connected to Him so that His very life may continue to blossom within us, enabling us to live in more faithful imitation of Him. He wants that bond to be strong and lasting. And He's given us the church in part to do precisely just that, to give us opportunity after opportunity to experience Him, to encounter Him, to know Him, and to serve Him. These are the God moments that the church wants to provide for us. through the sacraments, through the proclamation of God's word, through his devotion, through his teaching, and so many other things. Our church wants us to experience communal prayer through the myriad ministries that we can participate in, through the emphasis it places on family life, and even through our encounters with one another as we gather each week in the family of faith to give thanks to our God who has loved us first. For Catholics, our church is our home, that place where we stay connected, bonded to those we love, and to the one who is love. And so if you happen to know one of those persons for whom the church has lost some of its luster, if you're one of those people who struggle to make sense of the failures of some church leadership, if you're one of those, or who knows one of those, who each day have a harder time seeing the institutional church as necessary, you can't worry. You're not alone. My guess is that some of us, or maybe many of us, have had similar thoughts sometimes in our lives. And it depends upon what's going on in our lives or in the church. But let's not let those feelings prevent us from sharing in a tremendous blessing, or prevent us from allowing the church to do what it does best, and that is, keep us as branches fixed firmly to that vine, so that God's life and all that he is offering us may be continually poured into our hearts, our minds, and our souls. That takes a great deal of faith and trust. No doubt about it, but believing it can make all the difference in the world when it comes to our ability to experience and encounter God on every step of life's journey. To miss these opportunities would be a shame. God wants so much more for us. So let's give him these things in our hearts, in our minds. And we may always be confident that the connection formed by this gift we call church is deeper, stronger, and more lasting, and bonded to that bond. The church helps us keep it all in perspective. We are the branches. We are connected.